well today. So I haven't done a color and chat in quite some time now. I honestly can't remember the last time I did one. And I think the last one that I did was like a reading update. So I figured I could get on here and do some coloring and just kind of, you know, jibber jabber about a little bit of everything. So today I'm coloring in Johanna Basford's Worlds of Wonder. I'm sorry if you can hear like the ambulance in the background. I live close to like an exit from a highway, so a lot of the time I get the lovely sound effects of it. So I already started working on this page here. So far I'm just going through and doing all the greenery, and I figured I could like work on the leaves and such while we chit chat. So first thing first, I'm actually pre-filming this video, which is kind of a big deal for me because I tend to be not the most organized individual. But this video is going to go up on Thursday, August 19th, and actually I will be in an airplane at the time that this video goes up. I'll be somewhere over the Atlantic Ocean. I am flying from Germany, where I'm currently living, to the States to finally see my family again and my friends. So I moved to Germany October 2019 because I got into a master's program here. And the plan was to have my mother come visit the next spring, so spring 2020. But then, as we all know, the world kind of, you know, came to a halt with the pandemic and everything. So my mother wasn't able to come visit. She had rebooked the flight for the next fall, so fall 2020. Sorry, I'm having to like think the dates through. And that flight was also canceled because of the pandemic and everything. So I haven't seen my family in almost 2 years. So it's been a long time. It's been too long. I'm really close to my family, so it's been difficult. And I'm finally going over, you know, I'm able to travel to the States, and then also with the German like restrictions for travel right now, I am able to get back into Germany because, you know, I'm still in university. I'm still working on my master's. I have a job here, so I need to come back. So yeah, I'm super excited. This plan kind of happened, I don't want to say last minute, but it was definitely very quick. I bought the tickets, gosh, only a couple of weeks ago. So it's all been happening very quickly. My to-do list for today is absolutely ginormous, you know, just last minute things. And then I also have to make sure that I am prepared for like all the corona checks. So I went and got tested yesterday because you have to provide a negative test result from the last 3 days. So when I did that yesterday, I am fully vaccinated at this point, but you still have to do the test. So I did that. You know, packing. I'm also somebody who prefers to like give the apartment a good clean before I travel somewhere, just because I don't like coming back to a dirty apartment. Or, you know, it's not like I live in a swamp, Shrek style, but you know, still. So just kind of been running around like a chicken with my head cut off and trying to get everything done. But I figured I would sit down and color for a bit, you know, take a breather, but then also be able to pre-film for some of the stuff. So I am going to be filming while I am in the States. I will obviously not have all of my coloring books, just because there's just no way I am transporting all of them there and back. So I'm in the States for a little over a month. So I will only be bringing like two or three coloring books with me, which is, so that will be a completely separate video. I'm hoping to pre-film it after this one. We will see. So yeah, I'm very excited. So far my plans, like, you know, once I get there, include a lot of family time, you know, spending time with my mom, Also, in the 2 years that I have been in Germany, I have a new niece now that I've never met. So I'm very excited to finally meet her. I mean, I've met her like unofficially through FaceTime. Not the same thing, obviously. And then I also have a little nephew who, you know, was 1 year old when I left, and now he's almost three. So he's like a little character now. And yeah, I'm just very excited to see my family and catch up with everybody, and also see some of my friends, and, you know, but also just relax. I feel like the last 2 years have been really a weird time. And also, you know, again, I'm getting my master's. It's quite stressful. So it will be very nice to just kick back, hang out with my mom and the family cat, and just, yeah, kind of regroup, refocus. It's going to be lovely. And then I will come back at the end of September, and my next university semester, actually my last semester as well, starts, I think, the first week of October. Germany has different timings when it comes to semesters. So to an American ear, that might sound weird, but in Germany, they have a summer semester and a winter semester. So the summer semester ends, I think, September 30th, technically, and then the winter one starts. So that's kind of the quick little update. So yeah, I'll be in the States. I'm so excited. It's going to be weird also to go back. Again, it's just been 2 years. So when I was in my bachelor's, I lived in Norway for a few months, like a semester abroad. And I remember, like, when I came back to the States, the, like, kind of the shell shock, or just, you know, the, like, the culture shock was significant, even though I was coming back home. And that was only after a couple of months. So now that I've been here for almost 2 years, I don't know what to expect. Like, I'm not trying to pretend to be all fancy and I'm like, oh, I'm so European now or anything like that. But, you know, things are different. So we will see. My mom, being the mom that she is, scheduled me a dentist appointment the first morning that I'm there. So I get into Boston Thursday, like, afternoon. And then Friday morning, first thing in the morning, I have a dentist appointment. So I hope I'm not jet lagged, even though it's a 6-hour difference between where I'm coming from and to where I'm going. And, you know, I'll be flying. I think the overall travel time is like 11 something hours. I'm flying through Amsterdam. But yeah, we'll figure it out. But that's kind of the plan for the rest of the summer. I'm just relaxing. Hopefully I can get a lot of coloring done since I will be, you know, in vacation mode. But also, you know, the variety of the books I will be showing for the rest of the month. And September will obviously be also smaller because I just won't have everything with me. But that's okay. That's okay. I actually already pre-ordered something. Well, not pre-ordered. I ordered something off of Amazon, and I'm having it shipped to my parents' house. I ordered it last night. So, yep, just preparing. I ordered some supplies and a coloring book. I have a problem. But, you know, it's fine. It's absolutely fine. So since I'll be traveling for 11 plus hours, you know, one way, obviously I'm also coming back, I am kind of prepping entertainment material. I feel like I'm traveling with a child, even though it's just me. I am bringing my Kindle with me, and I am also downloading an audiobook from Libby. Also, if you don't have Libby, I would highly recommend getting it. It's a free app where you can connect your library card or multiple, and then you can just access their, like, ebooks and audiobooks and stuff. It's fabulous. I've been loving it. So I have
I have to read a book for my work book club. I'm falling behind. I purchased the book, like the ebook off of Amazon, because the wait at my library was like months. So I ended up just purchasing it. I forget the name of it. Gosh. Oh, I feel guilty. I don't remember the name. But yes, I have to read a book for the book club. And then I also have an audiobook right now. I just finished the audiobook for A Court of Thorns and Roses, and I was genuinely surprised by how much I enjoyed that book. I do have to say, I thought it was quite lengthy. The audiobook was like 14 hours or something, or 16, something like that. And then when I looked at the next one, because it is a series, I was like, oh my gosh, like the next one is 20 something hours, like 22, 23. And then it gets longer for the next one. So I don't possibly know, like, how, like, what are you writing about? Like, what's happening for that long? But I have it checked out, so I'll listen to it on the flight. I am somebody who can't really read or watch movies on the flight. Or like in cars, unfortunately, I get motion sick very, very easily. So for me, an audiobook is going to be perfect. I usually try to watch a movie if I feel like the flight's like quite steady and my stomach is doing well. But most of the time I will have to like stop partially through the movie, like relax for a bit and then go back to it, just because, again, I get very motion sick very quickly. It's unfortunate. It's something that I've had since I was a kid. Like when I was in elementary school, I was a child that always had to sit like next to the teacher because I would probably vomit, and they like had to be ready to take care of me. So yeah, good times, love that. I also haven't flown since October 2019, so we'll see how I do. I also can't sleep in airplanes. I am the weirdo that just sits there and like stares at a wall because, again, I can't watch movies or read and I can't sleep. So it's going to be a lovely time. And in case you're ever on a plane and you see somebody like that, please be nice to us. We're miserable. We're absolutely miserable. We are bored out of our minds and probably very sleepy. So that's my little public service announcement to please be nice to those people. Oh, I mean, please be nice to all people, but especially the ones that can't sleep or read or anything on airplanes. Our lives are horrid at that time. But yeah, I don't know. I'm just so excited. I know the first thing I'm going to do when I land is get myself a Dunkin' Donuts. I love me some Dunkin' Donuts. Dunkin' Donuts is kind of a rare thing here. Obviously, you know, it's an American brand. It's not even that common in some parts of the States. I'm trying to pick out a color. I'm trying to darken these apples a bit. But yeah, I'm gonna get myself a Dunkin'. So I land in Boston. And then to save my mother the trip into Boston, because if you've ever driven around Boston, you know it is an absolute nightmare. I will take a bus into New Hampshire, and then she can pick me up there. That way it saves her time. And again, she doesn't have to drive through the insanity that is Massachusetts. Again, if you have ever driven there, you understand. If you haven't, count your blessings. It is a flipping nightmare. Also, as I'm like rambling on here, I have to say these Brute Funner pencils have been winning me over like one picture at a time. I have been absolutely loving using them. Especially, I can't get over like the price also, like the price for what you get. I think these are smoother and like easier to blend than my Arteza pencils. And I mean, I love my Arteza pencils. They were like my holy grail for a long time. I think these just, I don't know, they just blend better and they're more buttery. I want to say butterier, but that's a hard one to say. Yeah, I don't know. Like, I know sometimes they can be a little hard to get your hands on. Then there's also like the square variety. Mine are obviously not the square ones. Mine are circular. But if you can get your hands on them, at least the circular ones, I can't speak for the square ones, I would recommend it. They are delightful. I know there was also some controversy about like the coloring books that you get with them. So at least like my pack came with some coloring books that the artwork was potentially like sketchily obtained. I had reached out to Amazon and I asked them and I said, you know, I just want to verify that, you know, I'm not using or this is not like pirated pictures. And Amazon representative assured me that everything was top notch. Whether that is a valid statement or not, I don't know. But I feel like as a consumer, I did do my due diligence. You know, I reached out to them, I asked, and, you know, just in case it is kind of sketchy, I have not featured any of those books on my channel ever since I showed off the pencils. I actually passed on the books to one of my friends. She doesn't have a YouTube channel. She just likes to do some art stuff in her free time, and I figured, you know, she can work on them if she wants to. If not, she can pass them on or donate them or something like that. But again, if you can get your hands on them, they are delightful. And I think the next like medium, almost said method, that I really want to try out is watercolor, whether it is watercolors, like the typical watercolors, or watercolored pencils. I just think it would be fun and nice for backgrounds, because I'm absolutely awful with backgrounds. I like never do them. I was thinking of what to do for the background for this picture, because obviously it's just centered. And I don't know, maybe I'll do a frame, but who knows? I'm just really, really bad with backgrounds. And I also don't own any distressings or anything like that. You know, I just have my pencils. So if I decided to do a background, it would be with pencils. I do also own markers, but I don't want to do markers in this book. I mean, obviously not alcohol markers, because I don't want to damage the image on the other side. And then watercolor markers are just too streaky. You know, I really like this book. This is definitely one of my nicer books. You know, Johanna Basford has really nice paper, and yeah. So we shall see. Knowing me, I'll probably end up getting watercolors or distress inks while I am in the US of A, but who knows. Also, I already got coffee on this, or some sort of food. But yeah, so I think I'll stop here. Thank you for listening to my random rambles. I'm really liking how this is turning out. I have to say, this like reddish brown is one of my favorite colors in this pack, because I feel like that could be a very hard color to find. That's a color that was missing from my Arteza set. So yeah, look out for this page in my completed pages. I think this might be a book I will bring with me to the States. I haven't decided yet. If that's the case, you'll obviously see more pictures in here. But yes, if you're not aware, this book is amazing. I think everybody's aware of that. But if you're not, here's your official statement. This book is amazing. But yes, thank you so much to everybody, and I will see everybody in the next one. Bye.